Hello everyone, welcome to StudyIQ. Before I start the video, let me tell you that we have started our Diwali sale and we are giving 33% off. Never before we have given this much discount on any sale. If you want to avail any pen drive course, then till 19th you can avail this. So a little over 8 days to go. So dial this number right now. In this video, I will bring to you part 2 of week 1 in English. Please remember, I have covered 92 questions and every week now I divide into 2 parts and I cover around 200 questions every week. So here we go. Our central government recently gave its approval for a memorandum of understanding with which country for upgradation of the Women's Police Training Center at Yamathin. Now, Yamathin is a place in Myanmar and India will help upgrade their Women's Police Training Center in Myanmar. Now, Myanmar is in news because of Rohingya issue. Rohingya Muslims, they primarily live in Rakhine state, also called Rakhine state of Myanmar. And then they are fleeing to Bangladesh and India. In India, we have 40,000 Rohingya. In Bangladesh, we have 6 lakh Rohingya. And there is a mission which is called Mission Insaniyat, which basically means we will help the Rohingyas. We will provide them food and shelter. And Myanmar's president is Mr. Htin Kyaw. This is very important. And de facto leader, of course, is Aung San Suu Kyi. But Htin Kyaw is the president. And Myanmar's capital is Nay Pi Taw. Nay Pi Taw. And its old name is Burma. Now, let me tell you one more important thing. If in the exam they ask you which country is helping us for police training, then the answer is Afghanistan. Then the answer is not Myanmar. Myanmar Women's Police Training Center in Myanmar? Yes, the answer is Myanmar. But men's police training, Afghanistan is helping us. And Afghanistan's president is Ashraf Ghani. Don't confuse him with Hassan Rouhani. Hassan Rouhani is the president of Iran, who has been posthumously, means after the death, given this prize called Anna Politkovskaya Award. It has been bestowed upon Gauri Lankesh. Her publication was called Gauri Lankesh Patrike. She was shot dead and she was fighting against the extremism in India. And also remember, there is one more person who has got this award. Pakistani activist Gulalai Ismailal. Gulalai Ismailal has also been given this award. Kundan Shah passed away. He was a famous what? So if you used to watch Doordarshan and you used to watch Nukkad or Vaagle Ki Duniya, Jaane Bhi Do Yaaro, all these movies, he was a director. He was a legendary director, Kundan Shah. First meeting of India-Australia Joint Steering Committee, it was recently held where Australia is fast becoming a strategic partner for India because of its strategic location, and it might also join India in the Malabar exercise along with America and Japan next year. Its capital is Canberra and it has a place called Melbourne, where we have a famous ground called Melbourne Cricket Ground, MCG, where the first ever cricket test match, official cricket test match was played. And remember, Australia's Prime Minister is Malcolm Turnbull, who was on a visit to India, few months back. So this meeting was held in New Delhi, the capital. Which country's National Communication Authority has given its approval for merger of Tigo with Airtel? Tigo is one of the largest telecom company in this this country, and now it is merging with Airtel edition of this country. So I'm talking about Ghana. Ghana's capital is Accra. It is a African country. And who is our Minister of State for Communication? Can you tell me? Manoj Sinha. And our Minister for Information Technology and Minister for Law and Minister for DT, that is Electronics, is Ravi Shankar Prasad. Which of the following companies has been awarded the Golden Peacock Award for Excellence in the Corporate Governance? Which company I am talking about? It is Tech Solutions. And this award was set up by the Institute of Directors in London, which is the capital of England. Tech Solutions got the Golden Peacock Award for Excellence in Corporate Governance. An international team of scientists has recently developed a low-cost instant test for which disease? They have done it for Zika and Dengue. Now, interesting thing is that Zika, Chikungunya and Dengue, all the three are spread by the same mosquito, which is called Aedes aegypti. However, the mosquito for malaria is different. The mosquito for malaria is the female Anopheles. Female Anopheles. So the answer is 1 and 4. What is the name of the new test that can detect the relapse of a cancer? One of the main problems with cancer is that after it has been removed, it can do a relapse. And now there is a test which is called Oncotype DX that can detect the relapse of the cancer. And remember, this research is done at the University of Manchester in England. Which of the following has launched the One Planet Academy OPA? It is an environment education portal or website for students and teachers. and it has been done by the World Wildlife Federation India. And also remember, our Environment, Forest and Climate Change Minister is Dr. Harshvardhan, who is also the Minister for Science and Technology. Science and Technology. United Nations recently ended their 11 years long peacekeeping mission, which is called MINUSTAH. In which country? They ended it in Haiti. UN Secretary General right now is Mr. Antonio Guterres. He is from Portugal. But also remember who is the United Nations High Commissioner for Refugee. His name is Filippo Grandi. Filippo Grandi is the United Nations High Commissioner for Refugee. And WHO head is Tedros Adhanom. And he is from Ethiopia. Capital of Ethiopia is Addis Ababa. It is a country in Horn of Africa. Madhya Pradesh Chief Minister Shivraj Singh Chauhan inaugurated the first community toilet for the exclusive use of transgender community. Now this toilet can only be used by the transgender community, and this might do away with some of the discrimination against the LGBT community. It has been opened in the capital of Madhya Pradesh, Bhopal. Madhya Pradesh has Panch National Park, Panna National Park, Bandhavgarh. It has Van Vihar, Satpura National Park. All these are important national parks in Madhya Pradesh. Now remember one very important thing here, that Madhya Pradesh Chief Minister Shivraj Singh Chauhan, but the governor is Om Prakash Kohli. And Bhopal is the second cleanest city of India after Indore. Indore is the cleanest city of India as per the Swachh Sarvekshan or Cleanliness Survey 2017. Which state government has approved the Mukhya Mantri Samuhik Vivah Yojana? Samuhik Vivah basically means when lot of marriages take place together, like 40,000 marriages, 50,000 marriages. So it is a mass marriage scheme, and government will spend 35,000 on each couple. It has been done by the government of Uttar Pradesh. Now Uttar Pradesh has a very important nuclear power plant called Narora. Narora power plant is in Uttar Pradesh, and there is a Dudhwa National Park. It is the only important national park in Uttar Pradesh, and governor of Uttar Pradesh is Ram Nayak. Chief Minister is Yogi Adityanath. Biannual talks were recently held between the chief of the border guarding forces of India and which country? From our side, BSF chief participated, border security force chief. His name is KK Sharma. And from this country, they have BGB, which is border guard Bangladesh. So the answer is Bangladesh. And also remember, in Bangladesh, India is building a Rupur nuclear power plant with the help of Russia. It is a nuclear power plant. Bangladesh Chief Minister Sheikh Hasina, Dhaka is the capital and Taka is the currency. And also in India, we have Kundankulam nuclear power plant, which we made with the help of Russia. It is in Tamil Nadu. In Tamil Nadu, we have another nuclear power plant called Kalpakkam. Reserve Bank of India has constituted a very high level task force on the public credit registry PCR for India under the chairmanship of which person? The name of this person is Y.M. Deosthali. And Reserve Bank of India recently gave their monetary policy also, where they have kept the repo rate unchanged at 6%. Also remember, Reserve Bank of India governor is Urjit Patel. Which state has topped the statistics released by the Home Ministry of number of active gun licenses, with 12,77,000 people authorized to carry weapon? So this state, you can say, is a mini US in that respect, that a lot of people carry gun. It is of course Uttar Pradesh. And second is Jammu and Kashmir, which has the maximum number of guns in India. Maximum is in Uttar Pradesh. Jammu Kashmir has Kishtwar National Park, Dachigam National Park and Hemis National Park. It also has Dr. Salim Ali National Park. Now remember, Hemis National Park, it is the largest national park in India. Which state or union government or lieutenant governor recently approved the government students higher education loan scheme? Government students will get higher education loan. It has been approved by a place where the governor is Anil Baijal. So he is the governor of Delhi, which is a union territory. Chief Minister is of Aam Aadmi Party. His name is Arvind Kejriwal. Which company has launched its new campaign called Hair to Create, which is to inspire young football talent in India? It is Adidas. Adidas. And remember that in India, Under 17 Football World Cup is going on, and Adidas is also the official sponsor. And Hyundai, which is a South Korean car company, is the official transport partner of the Under 17 Football World Cup, which is being played in India. Its final will be played in Salt Lake Stadium in Kolkata, which is the home ground of Mohan Bagan. Also remember one more thing, that Under 19 Asian Cricket Cup was shifted from Bengaluru to Malaysia. Maharashtra government has joined hands with which of the following organization to roll out a series of social development initiatives in Chandrapur district? And in Maharashtra, we have a nuclear power plant, two actually. One is Tarapur, which is already functional, and one is Jetapur, which is going on. Construction is going on. These are the two. And this organization is Tata Trust. Now, who is the chairman of Tata? His name is Mr. N. Chandrasekharan. He is the chairman of Tata. And there is a company of Tata called Tata Consultancy Service. It was the only Indian company in the top 50 companies declared by Forbes that are changing the world. It was at 30th position. And Maharashtra, we have Sanjay Gandhi National Park, Chandoli National Park, Tadoba National Park. We also have Gugamal National Park and Navegaon National Park. Who won the women's all-round title at the World Championship in Montreal? Montreal is a place in Canada. It is the headquarters of World Anti-Doping Agency. And the player I am talking about is Morgan Hurd. And Morgan Hurd is from America. And Simone Biles is a great gymnast. She is also from America. She had won also a lot of Olympic gold medals last year. Which state government has recently launched Matru Purna scheme? And you can see the chief minister here. His name is Siddaramaiah. He is from Karnataka. Karnataka is the answer. Please also remember Karnataka launched Indira Canteen also to provide subsidized food. And Anna Canteen was launched by Andhra Pradesh. Amma Canteen is of Tamil Nadu. And we also have another canteen which is called Deen Dayal Canteen of Madhya Pradesh. These are some important canteen. Rajiv Gandhi Canteen is started by Himachal Pradesh. So more and more states are starting their canteen, which is more of a socialist model to provide free food or less subsidized food. Now Matru Purna scheme is basically for pregnant and lactating mother, where a thali or a meal will be given only 25 rupees, you know, and iron tablets will also be provided because pregnant women generally have deficiency of hemoglobin and iron. So that's all you need to know. Karnataka has Ansi National Park, Banargatta, Bandipur, Nagar Hole, Kudremukha and Dandeli Tiger Reserve. Who bagged India's maiden gold medal at the World Wushu Championship that was held in Kazan in Russia? Russia's capital is Moscow and president is Vladimir Putin. The name of this great player is Pooja Kadyan. Pooja Kadyan. Who has been named as the event ambassador of the Under-19 World Cup 2018? Under-19 World Cup 2018 will take place in New Zealand. Capital is Wellington and the name of the player is Corey Anderson. ISRO, which is our own space agency, it is going to set up a research center for startups, teachers, environmentalists and entrepreneurs at which place? It will be set up in Guwahati. Guwahati is in Assam. Capital of Assam is Dispur. And in Assam, the chief minister is Sarbanand Sonowal of the Bharatiya Janata Party. And new governor is Jagdish Mukhi. Assam has Dibru Saikhova National Park, Sonai Rupai, Manas, Kaziranga, Orang. It has a Amchang Wildlife Sanctuary where encroachment, anti-encroachment drive was also launched by the government of Assam. Which country has appointed Vice Admiral Zafar Mahmood Abbasi as the new chief of Navy? This country is Pakistan. Pakistan. And Prime Minister is Shahid Khakan Abbasi. Government has undertaken a mass embryo transfer program in indigenous breeds under the scheme National Mission on Bovine Productivity. Bovine means your cattle. How many embryos will be transferred during the 9-month program? And our Women and Child Development Minister is Manika Gandhi and Health Minister is JP Nadda. Science and Technology Minister is Dr. Harshvardhan. Total 440 embryos will be transferred. Who has been appointed as the Deputy Director General of WHO? Director General of WHO, I already told you, his name is Tedros Adhanom and now she is the second most powerful in WHO after Tedros Adhanom of Ethiopia. Her name is Dr. Soumya Swaminathan. WHO is headquartered in Geneva in Switzerland. Switzerland's capital is Bern. They have a very important player also, Roger Federer. And Switzerland, you have two important places, Lausanne, which is the headquarter of International Olympic Committee, and Zurich, which is the headquarter of FIFA. Union Cabinet has recently apprised or informed of the Memorandum of Understanding with Switzerland on cooperation in the field of what? So Switzerland and India, we will cooperate in the field of railways. And there is an important committee which is called Anil Kakodkar Committee, which was on railway safety. And there is another committee, Bibek Devroy Committee, which was regarding the modernization of railways. Bibek Devroy is now the chairman of the Economic Advisory Council. And Railway Minister is Piyush Goyal and he is also the Coal Minister of India. Purushottam Lal Kaushik, he passed away. He was related to which field? He was a politician and he was also civil aviation minister in the Morarji Desai cabinet when there was a government after emergency 1977 to 1979, and in the Chaudhary Charan Singh government he was information broadcasting minister. Now of course information broadcasting minister is Smriti Rani. She is also the textile minister. She is a Rajya Sabha MP from Gujarat. Who has been named the new Prime Minister of Mongolia? Mongolia's currency is Togrog. They have a very important desert also, which is called Gobi Desert. And capital is Ulaanbaatar. Now, Gobi Desert is a cold desert. It is not a warm desert. The name is Ukhanagin Kurslek. Fitch Ratings. Fitch, Standard & Poor and Moody. They are called the top three credit rating agencies of the world. And all the three are American credit rating agency. That is why BRICS countries are pushing for their own credit rating agency. So Fitch Rating, they have said India's economic growth in this current fiscal, that is financial year 2018, will be what? They have downgraded the forecast from 7.4%. They have cut it by 50 basis points and they have said we will grow at 6.9%. According to International Monetary Fund, we will grow at 7%. What is the name of the 20-day program that was launched by Ministry of Tourism? Please note, earlier our Culture and Tourism Minister was Dr. Mahesh Sharma. Now he is only Culture Minister. Tourism Minister is new. His name is KJ Alphonse. He is from Kerala. And the name is Paryatan Parv. Paryatan Parv. October 4 to 10 is observed every year as what? It is observed as World Space Week. Our space agency is ISRO, headquartered in Bengaluru. Chairman is S. Kiran Kumar. America's space agency is NASA. And also remember, Russia's space agency is called Roscosmos. China is called CNSA. Europe's is called ESA, European Space Agency. And Japanese is called Japanese Aerospace Exploration Agency or JAXA. And who is our Minister of State for Space, Atomic Energy, PMO, Personnel, Grievances? His name is Dr. Jitender Singh. Which of the following has launched the app for Project Management Information System, that is called PMIS? This will be basically to track the progress of more than 3000 projects online in India. It is National Highway Authority of India, which is responsible for making all the roads in India. It is headquartered in New Delhi, and the minister for same for road and transport is Nitin Gadkari, who is now the minister for water resources, Ganga Rejuvenation and River Development also. He is a Lok Sabha MP from Nagpur. Now remember, NHAI builds the normal roads in India, that is National and State Highway, but the roads at borders is made by Border Road Organization. Pooja Kapoor has been made the next ambassador of India to which country? She is right now India's ambassador. She is to some other country. She is in Bulgaria actually. Capital of Bulgaria is Sofia. Now she has been made the brand ambassador of Macedonia. Now my first question for you today, and it is a difficult one. Which Indian great person? She has done lot of work, social reforms. She was born in Macedonia. The capital of Macedonia is Skopje. Write down the name of the person who was born in Macedonia. She is a saint. Which state government has signed a memorandum of understanding with MasterCard company to set up a center of excellence and enable safe and digital transactions? Which state I'm talking about? I'm talking about Andhra Pradesh. Andhra Pradesh has a dance which is called Kuchipudi. Kuchipudi is the state dance of Andhra Pradesh. Chandrababu Naidu is the chief minister. Andhra Pradesh also has India's first hyperloop project from Vijayawada to Amravati. Vijayawada airport has been renamed as NT Ramarao Amravati Airport. Amravati is the new capital of Andhra Pradesh, and it has Papikonda National Park and Lord Venkateshwara National Park. Also, Tirupati National Park has been renamed to Tirupati Airport has been renamed to Lord Venkateshwara Airport. Balaji Maharaj, Balaji Lord is called Lord Venkateshwara. So that's all you need to know. What is the name of the 6-year project that is launched by Union Environment Ministry and United Nations Development Program for protection of the Himalayan ecosystem? The highest Himalayan peak in India is Kanchenjunga. Himalayan peak, okay. Remember, K2 is not a Himalayan peak. It lies in the Trans-Himalayas, in the Karakoram range. So this is called Secure Himalaya. Secure Himalaya. And the highest peak in the world is Mount Everest. It is in Nepal. It is called Sagarmath. Its height is 8848 meter. India and Bangladesh, they have signed the third line of credit agreement of how much amount? This is to be spent for the infrastructure work, and this amount is $4.5 billion. It will be given by Exim Bank, Export and Import Bank of India. Government has constituted a very high level committee for proper management of water resources in the northeastern states, where many important rivers like Brahmaputra are there. It will be led by which person? It will be led by Mr. Rajiv Kumar. He is the vice chairman of Niti Aayog. Don't confuse him with Rajiv Gaba. Rajiv Gaba is the Home Secretary of India, and don't also confuse him with Rajnish Kumar. Rajnish Kumar is the new chairman of State Bank of India. There are 3 Indian states. They have signed a memorandum of understanding to boost the cultural ties or cultural relations under the Ek Bharat Shrestha Bharat program. Which of the following is not one of the 3 states? Arunachal Pradesh is there, Meghalaya is there, Uttar Pradesh is there, so Odisha is not a part of that. Odisha capital is Bhubaneswar, BJJ, the Biju Janata Dal is the ruling party, and Chief Minister is Navin Patnaik, who is the son of Biju Patnaik. And Uttar Pradesh has Dudhwa National Park, Meghalaya has a very important national park called Nokrek, capital is Shillong. Arunachal Pradesh has Mauling National Park and Nam Daf National Park. Chief Minister is Pema Khandu and Itanagar is the capital. First ever ASEAN India Music Festival, which was organized by the Ministry of External Affairs, Ministry of Culture and Seher, it was recently held at which place? It took place in Delhi. ASEAN has 10 countries. India is not a member of ASEAN, but it is a dialogue partner. And we have completed 25 years of relations with ASEAN in 2017, but we have also completed 25 years of diplomatic ties with Israel and Kazakhstan, all the 3. And ASEAN head of state will be our chief guest on 26 Jan 2018 Republic Day parade. Which state government is creating a 1.2 lakh acre land bank across the state for allocation to the industrial sector because it had difficulty in cutting the red tape and acquiring the land? This is Odisha. It has Simlipal Wildlife Sanctuary and Bhitar Kanika National Park. Bhitar Kanika National Park is in the Mahanadi Delta area and capital is Bhubaneswar and governor is Dr. S.C. Jamir. Which company has announced a partnership with Indian Railways Catering and Tourism Corporation Rail Connect app? The new chairman of IRCTC is Mr. Mal. Just remember Mr. M-A-L-L, Mal. and this company is MobiQuick. CEO is Bipinpreet Singh. Bipinpreet Singh, this company is headquartered in Gurugram and it is one of the main competitors of Paytm. Paytm's parent company is 197 Communication and its chairman is Vijay Shekhar Sharma. Teachers Day was celebrated on October the 5th. I am talking about World Teachers Day, not Indian Teachers Day. National Teachers Day we observe on the occasion of the birthday of Dr. Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan, who was the first Vice President and second President of India. So I am talking about World Teachers Day, which is observed on October the 5th. And this time the theme was Teaching is Freedom, Empowering Teachers. Who has become the first Indian ever to win a European racing championship by winning the Boss Grand Prix that was held in Imola in Italy. Italy's capital is Rome. Italy has the highest number of UNESCO World Heritage Sites, 53. Italy's Prime Minister is Paolo Gentiloni. And Rome is the headquarters of Food and Agriculture Organization and World Food Program. I'm talking about Mr. Mahavir Raghunathan and he is only 19 years old racer from Chennai. Which of the following has announced two strategic investments for the Indian market? Aadhaar-based authentication in its electronic signature solution and a local data center. These are the two important strategic investments. It has been done by Adobe and Adobe CEO is Mr. Shantanu Narayan. He's an Indian. Shantanu Narayan. Microsoft CEO Satya Nadella, also Indian. Google CEO Sundar Pichai, also an Indian. John Hastings, who recently announced his retirement from one day and test match, is a fast bowler from which country? He is a fast bowler from Australia. Three scientists have won the 2017 Nobel Prize for Chemistry and formula is RJJ. So Richard Henderson, Jacques Dobochet and Joachim Frank have won it. Gabriel Rafferty has not won it. And they did research on Zika and cryo-electron microscopy and a lot of things. NABARD, which is our agriculture bank for rural development, it was established in 1982 and chairman is Harsh Kumar Bhanwala. Harsh Kumar Bhanwala is the chairman of NABARD. NABARD has given a loan to Andhra Pradesh for its rural water supply, road and bridge project. How much loan it has given? It has given 273 crore rupees loan. Which state in India has become the first to set up an industrial training institute, ITI, exclusively for the differently abled people? Differently abled or disabled. They have made a ITI for the same. It is Assam. Asana. And where it has been set up? In Dibrugarh. Vice President Venkaiah Naidu, he is the 13th Vice President of India and Ramnath Kovind is the 14th President of India. So Venkaiah Naidu, he led the foundation stone for Inland Waterway Project in which state? It is built on Krishna River and it will connect Muktiala with Vijayawada. So again it is Andhra Pradesh and it is also having a Polavaram project. Central Water Commission of India, it has signed Memorandum of Understanding to support the Capacity Building Infrastructure Program in the Dam Safety under the Dam Rehabilitation and Improvement Project. So which IITs they have teamed up with? Central Water Commission. They have teamed up with IIT Roorkee and Motilal Nehru NIT Allahabad. So the answer is 1 and 2. Motilal Nehru NIT and IIT Roorkee. Intelligence India Software Solution, it has acquired which SAP software reseller and services provider? This is a direct question from merger and acquisition. This company is V-Centric Technology and both are based in Hyderabad, capital of Telangana. Which company has launched Neo? It is a servicing robot for Twitter. Twitter's Jack Dorsey is the CEO of Twitter. Jack Dorsey. And Twitter recently increased character limit from 140 to 280 now. You can now type in 280 alphabets. So I'm talking about HDFC Life Insurance. And HDFC Bank, Aditya Puri is the managing director. Yes Bank, Rana Kapoor. Axis Bank, Shikha Sharma. ICICI Bank, Chanda Kochar, State Bank of India, Rajneesh Kumar. And SBI Bank, ICICI Bank and HDFC Bank, these three banks are the only domestic systemically important banks in India, which means these banks cannot fail. Which mobile wallet company has relaunched its payment gateway called ZakPay? ZakPay. It has been launched by MobiQuick. And there is a mobile app which is called BPay. BPay has been launched by Fino Payment Bank, which is the fourth payment bank in India. Our External Affairs Minister Sushma Swaraj, she will lead a high-powered ministerial delegation to the ASEAN-India Pravasi Bharatiya Divas 2018. It will be celebrated in which country? It will be celebrated in Singapore. Singapore recently had their first female president ever, Halimah Yacoob. And their prime minister is Lee Hsien Loong. There was a 3-day international medical conference, ImTechCon 2017. It was recently held at which place? It was held in Union Territory Chandigarh, which is the capital of Haryana and Punjab both. And it was inaugurated or it was chaired by Haryana Governor Kaptan Singh Solanki. Haryana has two important national parks, Kalesar National Park and Sultanpur National Park. ONGC Videsh, it has announced to have completed the acquisition of 30% stake from United Kingdom's Tullow Oil in an oil block located in which place? ONGC, earlier Dinesh Saraf was the chairman. Now it is Mr. Shashi Shankar. Shashi Shankar is the new chairman of ONGC, Oil and Natural Gas Corporation. Our Oil and Gas Minister is Dharmendra Pradhan, who is also the new Skill Development Minister. He was one of the four ministers to be given a cabinet rank in the new cabinet reshuffle. The country I'm talking about is Namibia. Namibia, the capital of Namibia, not many people know, it is called Windhoek. Windhoek. And ONGC, till last year, it was the most profitable PSU, but it has been replaced by Indian Oil Corporation as the most profitable public sector undertaking in India. And ONGC and IOC both are Maharatan company. There are 7 Maharatan company in India, but now there are 8. 8th Maharatan company is Bharat Petroleum Corporation Limited, BPCL. BBC World Service has begun broadcasting in how many new Indian languages? They have started broadcasting in Gujarati, Marathi, Punjabi and Telugu. So the answer is 4. It is headquartered in London, capital of England. Which state's cabinet has approved the Mukhya Mantri Rural Road Repair Scheme? Under Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantees Act, also called Manrega, which assures you 100 days of work. And who is our labor minister? Earlier it was Bandaru Dutatreya, now it is Santosh Kumar Gangwar. He is the new labor and welfare minister in India. The state I am talking about is Himachal Pradesh, which has Pin Valley National Park. Now don't confuse Pin Valley with Silent Valley. Silent Valley is in Kerala and Neora Valley is in West Bengal. Neora Valley National Park. So don't confuse. Himachal Pradesh also has Great Himalayan National Park. European Investment Bank will provide $500 million loan support with which metro project in India? Which metro project in India is being financed by European Investment Bank? It is the Namma Bengaluru, the Bengaluru Metro. And Bengaluru has ISRO headquarter and Indian Institute of Science is also in Bengaluru. It is the capital of Karnataka. It is a science city, space city, IT city, call it whatever. And also remember, Lucknow Metro is the first metro in India to have their own FM. Central government has given their approval for signing and ratification of the extradition treaty between India and which country? Extradition treaty means if there is a offender in that country, it can be extradited to India under law. So it is, we have done it with Lithuania. The capital of Lithuania is Vilnius. It is a neighbor of Russia, Estonia, Latvia, Lithuania, Kazakhstan, Uzbekistan and all these. A temple with a 100 feet tall statue of Pradhan Mantri Modi. So it's a good news for Bhakts that there is a temple now of Modi where they can go and worship. And it will be in Meerut, Western UP. Now he is not the first. This is not the first temple of Modi. There is a temple in Rajkot in Gujarat also of Modi. And also remember, the other celebrity temples are also there in India, like Mahatma Gandhi temple is there in Odisha, Sonia Gandhi temple in Andhra Pradesh, Amitabh Bachchan temple is in South Kolkata, Sachin Tendulkar temple is in Bihar, and Mayawati temple is in Uttar Pradesh. Azerbaijan capital is Baku. It has extended the oil production contract with ONGC Videsh, Bharat Petroleum, Chevron and other consortium partners till which date? They have done it with till 2049. Jacqueline Fernandez, she is an actress from Sri Lanka, but she has also done movies in India also. Jacqueline Fernandez has been named as the brand ambassador of which club for Indian Super League football? And this has become the first Indian football club to have a female brand ambassador. It is Delhi Dynamos FC. Reserve Bank of India has recently opened their branch in which place? They have opened in capital of Dehradun. Capital of Uttarakhand, Dehradun. And Uttarakhand has the second highest population of tiger in India after Karnataka. They have Rajaji Tiger Reserve, Jim Corbett National Park. They also have Govind Pashu Vihar. And remember, State Bank of India, they opened their recent branch in Singapore. State Bank of India. Central government has approved setting up of a new center to conserve turtles at which place? Turtles are mostly seen in Odisha at the Gahir Math Beach. These are called olive ridley turtles. Now there is a center for the same which will be opened in Allahabad in Uttar Pradesh. Andaman Nicobar administration, they have operationalized an alternate sea route from Port Blair to which island? Andaman Nicobar, the capital is Port Blair. Now there is a route now till Baratang Island. European Securities and Market Authority, which is called ESMA, it has recognized the clearing arm of which Indian exchange as a third country central counterparty, TCCCP. It is Bombay Stock Exchange and National Stock Exchange both. So the answer is 2 and 3. Prime Minister Modi, he laid the foundation stone of AIIMS at which place? AIIMS will be built at which place? It will be in Bilaspur, Bilaspur in Himachal Pradesh at a cost of 1350 crore rupees. Power Finance Corporation, it has approved the proposal for merger of which of its wholly owned subsidiary with the company. That is, this sub company or subsidiary will now be merged with the parent company. It is called PFC Green Energy. And who is our minister for renewable energy? His name is RK Singh. He is also the minister for power. SEBI, Securities and Exchange Board of India, headquartered in Mumbai, and chairman is Ajay Tyagi. It has appointed a panel on corporate governance. It is led by which person? They have also submitted their report. His name is Uday Kotak. He is the chairman of Kotak Mahindra. Which non-government organization in India, they have launched a book. They have launched a book for the visually impaired, the blind people. The book is called The Singing Tree. The organization is Orbis India. Orbis India. First time, WWF World Wildlife Fund, they have said that snow leopard has been seen in India, and we have a photographic proof also where it was seen. It was seen in a village in Arunachal called Thembang. Thembang village in Arunachal Pradesh. So the answer is Arunachal. It has Mauling National Park and Namdaf National Park. Prime Minister Modi recently inaugurated the Golden Jubilee Year celebrations of which organization? This was established in 1980. This organization is the Institute of Company Secretaries of India, in short ICSI. How much amount has IFC, International Finance Corporation, invested in the 5-year underrated masala bond issuance of the Fullerton India Credit Company? Masala bonds are the rupee denominated bond for the overseas investor, and our commerce minister is Mr. Suresh Prabhu. He is the ex-railway minister. So it is $76 million. The first regional language version of the GST rate finder was recently launched in which language? Now you know that GST rate finder is a mobile app launched by the Ministry of Finance. Arun Jaitley is the minister for the same. Now it has been launched in Telugu. It was launched by Governor Narasimha, who is the governor of Andhra and Telangana both. Which ministry has been adjudged as the best department for its contribution during Swachhta Pakhwada? Swachhta Pakhwada, this minister is JP Nadda, and he is the health minister of India. Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank and Asian Development Bank, they are co-financing a loan of how much amount for India to improve the power transmission network and expand the use of renewable energy? They are co-financing $100 million. AIIB is headquartered in Beijing. Asian Development Bank is headquartered in Manila, which is in Philippines, which is the capital of Philippines. Asian Development Bank president is Takehiko Nakao. Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank, the president is Mr. Jin Lekan, who is the ex-finance minister of China. How many countries have been suspended from weightlifting for a year by the International Weightlifting Federation? How many countries? International Weightlifting Federation president is Mr. Tamas Ajan. Tamas Ajan. So they have suspended 9 countries. Which company has launched India's first online bidding platform for residential and commercial property? You can bid for property online now. This is Magic Bricks. And Mr. Sudhir Pai is the CEO of Magic Bricks. Which institute in India has won the most clean campus award? And this was awarded by All India Council for Technical Education. The cleanest campus is of Manipal Institute of Technology. I am also an alumni of Manipal University, by the way. Manipal Institute of Technology, it is in Manipal. It is in Udupi in Karnataka. Railways has exempted the passengers from payment of service charges on tickets booked online till world date. Railway has said that we will not charge any service tax if you book the ticket till March 2018. By the way, 33% of the revenue of the IRCTC comes from service charge, and our railway minister is Piyush Goyal. As per the newly issued directions by RBI, a non-banking financial company and peer-to-peer shall have a net owned funds of higher as specified by the bank, or how much amount? 20 million rupees. Center has set up high-level forum for rolling out 5G in India by which date, by which year? 5G is fifth generation. It will be launched in India 2020, and Manoj Sinha is the communication minister. As per a study done by Norton Antivirus, it is owned by Symantec company, which country has reported the highest level of online harassment in Asia-Pacific region? Out of 10 people who are doing internet in this country, 8 say that they have been online harassed, verbally abused. It is, of course, India. Who has won the 2017 Nobel Prize for Literature? This is one of the most important questions. He is a Japanese. He was born in Japan, but he was born in Nagasaki, but he lives in Britain now. So his name is Kazuo Ishiguro. And remember the name of the book also. The book is called The Remains of the Day. Which company has launched MARQ? It is a private label for large appliances. It is Flipkart. Kalyan Krishnamurthy is the CEO, and Sachin and Minni Bansal, they are the founders of this company. It is headquartered in Bengaluru. NIOS, National Institute for Open Sourcing, it is going to offer a course called Diploma in Elementary Education for the untrained teachers in the elementary education system. They will be trained by which year? They will be trained by March 2019, and education comes under HRD, and therefore it is Prakash Javadekar is the minister for HRD. Who has topped the Forbes list? Who is the richest Indian? Richest Indian is Mukesh Ambani. Mukesh Ambani, and Azim Premji of Wipro is the second richest Indian. Which country has approved a new anti-terrorism law? The capital of this country is Paris, which will host 2024 Olympic Games. It is also the headquarters of Organization of Cooperation of Economic Development. Organization for Economic Cooperation and Development, OECD, and UNESCO, both are headquartered in Paris. He is the president of this country, Emmanuel Macron, of the party En Marche. It is France. So this was the high voltage part 2 of first week of October. With this, I finish first week, and second week part 1 will be uploaded tomorrow, same time. Thank you for watching.